Hi, I'm Jared Hillam. Imagine that you had purchased a computer and expensed it to your company. You fill out the expense report and follow the process, so you're expecting to get paid back soon. Now, on the accounting side of your company, somebody sees an unusually high expense report, which prompts them to give you a call. Can you imagine your response to the call being, "Well, you're the dollars guy, so you figure it out." Now, it is true that the accountant is the dollars guy, but not only would that response make it harder for you to get paid back, but the accountant simply doesn't have the story behind why you need a computer. Well, the same is true for your data. The data guys are in IT, but they don't create the data. So when your data is inconsistent between systems and it doesn't roll up well, guess who they're going to call? Yeah, it's you, the business user. But unfortunately, data problems don't come in dribs and drabs, like our expense scenario, but rather in mass quantities of transactions and interactions inside application systems. So setting up a one-time call or a meeting isn't going to fix the issue. And this is where so many organizations end up with a no man's land. IT doesn't have enough context to fix the data, and the business users believe that it's an IT issue. The impasse causes lots of problems, which will reveal themselves in a variety of ways. For example, reports don't roll up right because the data isn't correct. Different systems have their own customer records. Standing up a new system requires lots of rework. And business rules end up being something somebody puts in a departmental spreadsheet to get figures to add up. Cross-selling is nearly impossible because there isn't a consolidated profile of the customer's interactions with the company. And the list just goes on and on and on and on. Fixing this issue requires a cat herder. It requires somebody that can get a lot of people to do something they don't want to add to their busy schedules, which in this case is data governance. So in this video, we're going to talk about what a data governance program is and what roles people should have. A data governance program is something designed to help the organization tackle this no man's land head on. And this is done by organizing all the critical stakeholders involved. Now, unfortunately, in many organizations, this ends up becoming a donut meeting. You know, the meeting that everybody goes to get free donuts. So to make the data governance program work, you need to follow a couple of basic guidelines. First, IT should not own the data governance program. They don't create the data. Now, IT should be a participating member on the data governance team, but having them own it creates the wrong impression out of the gate. Second, IT should develop the frameworks to enable the data governance process to be repeatable and scalable. This includes master data management software deployments, data quality software deployments, and even data retirement software deployments and security software deployments. I think you get the idea. Third, this means business stakeholders should own the data governance program, and here's why. They will be the point people in assessing all the changes that need to be made to the data. And there will likely be process changes that need to take place to ensure that data quality issues don't continue. Also, the business process owners may need to come together to agree on terminology. For example, a warehouse management team may believe that the term delivery means that the product has left the dock, but the sales team calls delivery when it arrives at the customer's doorstep, while the support team may call the delivery when the product has been installed. If we're going to set standards, we need to have either agreement on naming conventions or logic to keep the naming conventions intact so the IT team can build a framework around it. And finally, some of the rules that will need to be in place will require some political sponsorship to come down with the tie-breaking decisions. Let's not forget that some people have spent their life's work building some of these systems and processes, so there's a lot of personal investment we're dealing with in many organizations. Fourth, data governance meetings should be driven by a rolling 6 to 12 month plan so they can track progress against the desired end state. This keeps the meetings from being donut meetings, and it makes tactical assignments and their relevance to the end goal something that is clear in everybody's mind. Fifth, make sure that the business participants have clear roles to play. For example, and this is just an example, owners should provide the political tie breaks and instructions for IT on setting up or changing policies within the MDM tools. Data stewards should advise owners on policy decisions and approve data changes by the users. Users should determine record corrections, which the MDM tool couldn't decipher automatically, and also provide recommended rules or updates for the data stewards so they can reduce the number of required manual updates. So there's no cookie-cutter way of setting up a data governance team, but Intricity has helped build data governance programs within a variety of political corporate landscapes. I recommend that you visit Intricity's website, talk with one of our specialists, because we can help you design a data governance program that doesn't end up in a pile of stale donuts. If you're the cat herder within your organization, click on our data governance white paper, which will help you build a justification for your program.